Hey guys, you Broker Bros, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Chrome Mode. Where last month I played the first leg against Bayern Munich in the semi-final of the Champions League, and in this episode I'm playing the second leg. Hey. Also in the last episode I picked up a win over West Ham in the Premier League. Following this game I will have a Premier League game against Newcastle. Will probably be the last Premier League game you see this season, depending on scheduling. I don't know when they're going to place the Champions League final, you know. So I will let you guys know probably by the end of this episode, because I should know once Spurs and Monaco reach their conclusion the day after this, because my second leg is going on before theirs, because their first leg went on first. Spurs were leading 1-0 from that match, so at the moment an All English final is still on.
Joins up front with Daniel Sturridge.
It's just funny because Spurs might reach. Spurs will have the chance to win the Champions League final, even though they don't look like they're going to finish in the top four. I don't even know where they are in the league, to be honest. The top four, for the last time I checked, was the same in top four. For, normally it's Crystal Palace. It's been for most of the season. That's Palace, Arsenal, and Chelsea. With Manchester United, some were just below them.
Should be! He's kept it out. Shot. It's a fine strike, but not quite what he was hoping for.
But when he's hit it, I'm sure he would have thought that was going to bulge in the back of the net. Not quite, though.
Now, the order, I don't know the order, I don't know. Well, maybe Manny Ayer in the top four, I don't know. Well, I mean, I can check after this match, but
Javi Alonso.
It really doesn't matter, because it's probably going to reach. It's probably a little changed about 15 times by the time I do check it.
In strongly. It's Mane.
Shot off! Oh, well saved!
It'll be a throw, no nonsense clearance from the defender. Coutinho!
That was a terrible shot.
Javi Alonso.
A return ball.
Tried to tackle here, and he's done that. Alexis Sanchez moving the opposition around with their play, these two players.
That'll play.
Roberto Firmino.
Nathaniel Klein.
There goes the cross.
Oops, the ball in, and Lam is there to prevent the ball getting anywhere near Sadio Mane. The ball almost fell perfectly for Dama. It will fall for Alaba! No such luck. One moment, that would have been. Ooh, a really good goal. Oh, what, the cup and. No. Less.
Thiago. Ball with Lam. A timely challenge. Clearly a throw. Not quite clear whose throw it is. David Alaba. Trying to find a way through here. Probing away. that's the way to defend.
Was hoofed clear by Jerome Boateng.
Coutinho.
That's the ball I'm looking for me. Oh. Alright. Keep his hand. Coutinho. Hey, through Hulk. Hulk. Mane! Oh.
Could have got through there, but the defender was absolutely on top of his game. Foul against Liverpool.
Eric Chen has just fouled Thiago as he was trying to retrieve the ball. Coutinho.
Picked off that pass, and now he's got the ball.
Well, doesn't get past Hummels. Muller back to Alonso. The two Spaniards have a passing game between them. They're getting Muller involved. Vidal. Back to Alonso. Vidal! Oh, he threw! Oh, the knife by the post. A Turo Vidal shift. Pulled the goal back there for Bach. A great move from Bach. And with no end result. Well, this would be a kick in the teeth. Here comes Sadio Mane! And he buries it. What a kick in the teeth that is. This. Sadio Mane.
Scored right on half time. The opposition just the opposite.
Arturo Vidal should have made 2 on aggregate and 1-0 on the night to Bayern Munich. From the result, holding goal kick. The ball got to Sadio Mane. He got through on goal. Oh, and he slots it home. 3-0 on aggregate. Eight. 1-0 on the night to me, and now Bayern Munich must
add up the scores.
Just win by 3 goals. You're just sitting there or wondering to yourself, wait, what? 3-1 would do. Well, yes, 3-1 would do them. And because then they'd win on away goals. But Bayern Munich won't want to win on away goals. They'll want to say they beat.
So the referee blows and it's off and running for the second half.
Really beat. That Toro Vidal will miss. He have
Hummels. Thiago.
Unimaginable. Oh.
It's Mane.
Or replica. I shouldn't know. Throughout the rest of this time.
The approach play looked very encouraging. Now Sadio Mane. Now the shot!
Hey, used Hummel. Close to his advantage. The ball's come to Emery Chan! Ooh.
Well, they've got a corner.
Emery Chan, who came through the youth academy at Bayern Munich, if I'm not mistaken. Or was it Bayer Leverkusen that he signed for Bayern Munich? No, it was Leverkusen we signed.
Was easy on the eye.
Yeah, he was at Bayern Munich briefly when Pep Guardiola was starting out there. Mane! And Sturridge won't get the chance to
get one chance and
do anything with the rebound because Sadio Mane was a foot offside.
And it's been
why it didn't call it earlier, I don't know.
Sure we're going to enjoy that as well.
Renato Sanchez comes on again. Which reminds me, I looked into Renato Sanchez and I accidentally made an inquiry again. And I went to...
We're quite a dangerous position now.
And to short list, I accidentally... he went into Hit Dex too many times and accidentally in court heard about him as well. So I now know roughly the price that Bayern Munich might be wanting from summer. Should I decide Renato Sanchez is a player I want to add to the squad? Dude! I don't know why it went right past Sadio Mane. Which is who I passed it to game. Dude should have done better. Witzel was coming on for Thiago. It's completely reversed it. Last time Witzel came on for
Coutinho.
Now the manager. What happened to him?
He's got the ball away from him with a tackle. And he could get away.
But in the first,
attack has fizzled out here.
Witzel came on for Alonso, and Thiago went off for Renato Sanchez. And this time, Renato Sanchez came on for Alonso, and Thiago was replaced by Witzel. And then Vidal got injured somehow. I'm not sure how he did that. Sadio Mane steals the ball from Mats Hummels and buries it. That is why his short goal kicks are very dangerous play. Mats Hummels was trying to get into a position to make up for his mistake of losing the ball, but it was too late. The ball went past him. It was in the net. Sadio Mane has 6 goals now in the Champions League. I think that puts him joint top goal scorer? Or something like that? That puts him right up there anyway. So it wouldn't be a real competition that Mane has taken some part in if he wasn't scoring a lot of goals. So now he's going to be hunting a hat-trick before the end of this game.
Should win now, shouldn't they? 2-0 here, not much time to go. What impact will that have on the next game? Well, Liverpool go up against Newcastle United after this. And now
Bayern Munich must be thinking back to that tour over that we'll miss towards the end of the first half. How crucial it's not for turning out to be. He's Sadio Mane. Hey, no. Her perfect. Hints anymore. Her damage being done. Would Witzel not have been better off taking a yell for the team there? Her and just giving away the free kick? He was taking a huge risk that Neuer would be equal to Mane's shot. For his sake, his gamble paid off, but would he not have been better off to say, fuck it, and I'll take the yellow card, or as long as Liverpool don't get what might be a guaranteed goal from a guy who has 40 plus goals in the Premier League, and now a hat trick in this game, regardless?
He'll never forget. Well, no wonder he's wheeling away in a super celebration.
Yes, I could score. Heard away Emery. The same. He was lurking. And that was always going in the back of the net, wasn't it? That's the level of confidence that you deal with when you have a player in high form, which Sadio Mane is.
Means it's 5-0.
Interesting, Renato Sanchez just gave me one of those, applauding a good goal animations. Is he already signing himself on a Liverpool contract?
two legs. And I think they deserve
it. His head is being turned by my inquiry. He perhaps. Questions. The first answer. Is I am true to the final hole now to find out who I will be playing. There you can see he Spurs his 1-0 lead from the first leg. Against Monaco.
Champions Cup. Semi-final, second.
Now to sim ahead and find out who I will be playing in the final. Yeah, look, Spurs aren't even in the top six. They're 11th. So, yeah. They're 11th, and they might be in the Champions League final. They're not even going to be in the Europa League next season. We know who Spurs' love affair with the Europa League. Oh wow, I'm actually... Really, Emery? Really? Does the game want to tell me who won that match? I guess I'll just pop in here. And the answer is... Spurs. Are they held on or are they added to? Who? Wait. But Spurs are in the final. They join me in the final of the Champions League. So it is an all-English final for the first time since 2008. When Chelsea played Manchester United in John Terry's most infamous game. And to Chelsea fans who like to laugh about those Steven Gerrard slip, I will point that game out to you guys and say John Terry was doing it first. I'll make a few slight alterations before starting the game against Newcastle. Oh, Crystal Palace have almost secured a Champions League spot. They only need to get pretty much one more point in their last two games.
think there's anyone likely in the Newcastle United lineup to be the man of the match today.
This is none of my business at the moment. I will focus a bit on that one. When it comes to who the NBC is going to go over the final league table.
It'll be a different approach now they've already got their hands on the
season. Actually, in the last episode, I didn't even notice it until I was looking at the news just before the news for the match. We'll see what it said about my inquiry for Renato Sanchez. I spotted it that Bournemouth were relegated from the Premier League. And you guys probably noticed it when I showed you guys the table briefly. Bournemouth were third last, which means all three teams are relegated with two games to remain. So it's only the top four spots that are open. One team will be disappointed.
What a fine save!
Crystal Palace, which, as you saw, are current second at 70, Chelsea at 69 in third, and both Manchester United and Arsenal are tied at 65, with Arsenal ahead of an I assume goal difference?
Check Giotte.
So, makes it interesting between those 14 teams battling out for three spots.
Well, he's
two that are guaranteed. One, whoever finishes fourth, or might not even get into the Champions League anyway, because they'll have to qualify.
Amiobi. And there is some backup for him in this position.
They've opened them up here. Oh, just got to keep calm. It's a goal they've scored here.
Moya makes good on his second by the pitcher. He's made a huge mistake and is punished. Tucks it home for his fourth goal of the season in the Premier League.
So the first goal, it's 1-0. Throw in for Liverpool. On to the attack now.
Here's David.
Stopped emphatically and just as well.
The approach will clear it.
Here comes the cross. That was a good crossing position, but not a good cross. Amiobi.
Also, I pointed this out in the last episode when I played West Ham, but his appearance in this match means he's in. I have played.
Well saved.
Kevin Stewart the exact same amount of times in 1 month than Middlesbrough had all season up until I recalled him from his loan. So
the shot's on. Oh, he was away. Alan, he was
no reason I will not be doing business with any more Premier League teams loan or selling related. I might buy from a rival Premier League team if the need arises. If I need a player and I know they can supply a good quality.
Shots on here.
But I have no need for player yet.
Is
Emery Chan stuff may only further my interest in Renato Sanchez.
Plenty of time left all of the second half, of course. Challenges for the ball.
In fact, maybe I can use Emery Chan in some kind of swap deal.
Reading of the by anticipating the pass. Oh, too early, offside.
Doesn't need to go as soon as he did there.
That's interesting. That is a very pondering thought. Think about now. That's something I could do. I mean, there are other options I could go for. I mean, I could go for another. Give me a Toro Vidal, perhaps?
And in goes the cross.
Or maybe I could look to the Premier League, because there's some quality bit. Or that's calling three dots. And no, it's thinking it. I'm not talking, but the dabbing dipshit. It's Paul Pogba. There's quality. I can think of other players that they're quality in. But I think Renato Sanchez would be my number one target. And look at that. Two games for me, one goal. Two good games in a month for me. Two games in.
Ball on the shot for him to
two Premier League games in a row for me. One goal from those two games. Two games in God knows how. Two from like 32 that Middlesbrough played him in. Again, another reason why I will not be doing any more business with Premier League, probably in terms of buying, I mean, selling or loaning a player to, because they just did I'm just improving my rival. And if I loan the player, they don't fucking play him. If they do, they don't play him enough. Two games of the whatever isn't good enough.
An easy goal in the end. The kind that you wouldn't expect to get at this level.
After this game, I have two games remaining. If I play Kevin Stewart in one of those games, which is the plan, that will mean he made more appearances for me in 1 month than he did throughout the rest of the season for Middlesbrough.
Now he's looking.
He's got his shot off now.
And that says a lot.
Good block.
And yeah, this will be the last Premier League match you see. And I know some people would want to see the Premier League thing, but you know, it's the same animation from last season. The only thing that would be different would be that it'd be De Gea lifting the trophy instead of James Milner.
And he's in there with a header. Wonderful goal. Corner put into the right area and then put into the net. They'll think it was sloppy defending, but the attackers will be delighted.
Thiago Alorio makes it 4-0.
That was a top class goal.
Nice header from the corner. I don't know what this idiot is doing. He was never going to get anywhere near it.
So they're looking for more at 4-0. Jonjo Shelvey.
The odds were always against him.
Just over a quarter of an hour left on my watch. On to the attack now. Newcastle want to make a substitution here. Good challenge. The break is definitely on. Shots on here. Goal!
David Sutton makes it 5-0.
Well, scoring in any game is worthy of celebration. When you get two, it is special. He is feeling that special delight at the moment.
There is a third of the season in the Premier League.
We've got 10 minutes left on the clock. What about Liverpool's next game?
Yeah, they're playing West Bromwich Albion in the next match. And I don't think they'll find too many obstacles in the way.
He went in well. Attacking well here. Time for the opposition to spoil Liverpool's day, but they haven't looked like doing it because Liverpool haven't let them look like doing it. It's a good place to win the ball here. Jack Colback. Chunk of added time here, 3 minutes. Jack Colback. Ami Obi. Jonjo Shelvey. Well, they're attacking here. Might be a chance for Newcastle. Well, they've been thwarted here. And that's a win confirmed.
There's the end of the game.
They never let up, did they? They kept on going to make this a very big margin of victory.
My manager shakes the hand of the manager who I guess is supposed to look like Rafa Benitez, even though it looks nothing like him. So, there's that. Chelsea beat West Brom since Crystal Palace didn't play. I mean, Chelsea are back up in second place.
Stoke City, yep. Nil. Everton, 2. Sunderland, 3.
Oh, Arsenal played their 37th game.
Brighton and Hove Albion.
A draw means that Manchester United can pass them out, you know.
West Ham United, 2. Arsenal,
Man United win. They'll go on to 38 points in the...
At the top of the table remain...
It will be in their hands... Whether they go into where they finish in the top four for this season or not. Chelsea's win all but secures their place. Actually, I think it does secure their place in the top four.
Arsenal with 66 points. In fifth, Manchester United with 65 points, with a game in hand on the team above. In sixth, Everton with 53 points. In 7th, Manchester City with 48 points, with a game in hand on the team above. In 8th, Leicester City with...
Here it finally goes up to 72.
...with 17 points. And then, reading up the table, 2nd bottom, Norwich City with 19 points, with a game in hand on the team above. 3rd bottom...
There's 6 points ahead of Arsenal. They will 100% secure... place, but they would need Manchester United to lose to whoever they're playing. I don't think Chelsea have anything to worry about, even if Manchester United don't lose, which I don't think they will. I say they'll draw or win. Maybe they will lose. I don't know. Let's see. They drew. Crystal Palace. this one, though, which means they are definitely going to be in the Champions League next season. Actually, only Manchester United win now that I think about it could have... actually, no. Because then that would put Arsenal... Chelsea are in the guaranteed in the Champions League. So Manchester United and Arsenal will be battling out on the last day as they are on the same points. I can only imagine if they were playing each other, that would be fantastic. Unfortunately, I don't think that's the case. But imagine if it were. Imagine if it were. But yeah. I will play either games against West Brom and Sunderland, I think is my last game. I will do those off camera, but yeah, that's it for the Premier League games for the season. In the next episode, you will see the final two games of the season, the FA Cup final. Against Leicester and the Champions League final against Spurs is in episode 50 of my FIFA 17 Liverpool promo. So a landmark way to finish ish season who is a can't miss next. On Friday, I was going to say next Friday because this is recorded on Friday. Thanks for watching, I'm enjoying, and until next time, I hope you all have a very nice day. Peace.